About this walking out, I'd like to explain.
The girl in the pink dress, I imagine.
You still don't miss a thing, do you?
Your wife.
For the past 11 months. She was so looking forward to the play, she got a little overexcited. She's only 18, still almost a child. I'm waiting.
For what?
For you to tell me what an old fool I've become. To have fallen under the spell of youth, beginnings, the blank page.
The page that has been written on and rewritten.
With great style. Some things, schnapps, for example, improve with age.
Let us hope that proves true of your little bride. So, you took her home, tucked her up in her little cot with her rattle and her woolly penguin.
Figuratively speaking.
And then you came to me.
I wish you'd ask me why.
Why did you come to me?
For old time's sake, for curiosity, to boast about my wife, to complain about her, perhaps. Now, why am I being such a lawyer about it? This afternoon, when I was taking my nap,
you take afternoon naps now.
I had the most delightful dream.
About?
You.
And what were we doing?
Well, as a matter of fact, we were in that little hotel in Malmo. We'd been basking in the sun all day, and you...
And my back got so burned, it was agony to lie down, so...
As vivid as... Well, very vivid. So you see, my motives for coming here are what might be called mixed. Funny.
Oh, no, not at all.
How familiar all this is.
Oh, yes, nothing's changed. The same old inevitable routine. Uppsala one week, Arebro the next.
Well, it still has its compensations.
Yes, no, no.
That's a rather ambiguous answer. You must at least at times be lonely.
Dear Frederick, if you are inquiring about my love life, rest assured it is quite satisfactory.
Ah, I see. And if I may ask at the moment?
A dragoon. A very handsome, very married dragoon with, I'm afraid, the vanity of a peacock and the brain of a pea. But the physical proportion...
Don't specify the vegetable, please. I'm easily deflated. Desiree. Perhaps a little more schnapps.
Help yourself.
Who's this?
That. That's my daughter.
Your daughter? I had no idea.
She happened.
She's charming. Where is she now?
Oh, she's with my mother in the country. She used to tour with me, then mother swept up like the wrath of God to save her from me. You never knew my mother. She always wins our battles. A little schnapps for me too, I think.
Yes, of course.
I apologize for all this squalor.
On the contrary, I have always associated you, most happily, with chaos. So, I think it's time I talked about my wife, don't you?
Boast or complain?
I expect. She lightens my sadness, she livens my day. She bursts with a kind of madness, my well-ordered ways. My happiest mistake, the ache of my life. You must meet my wife. She bubbles with pleasure, she glows with surprise. Disrupts my accustomed leisure and ruffles my ties. I don't know even now quite how it began. You must meet my wife, my Anne. 1,000 whims to which I give in, since her smallest tear turns me ashen. I never dreamed that I could live in so completely demented, contented a fashion, so unlike, so winning, so unlike a wife. I do think that I'm beginning to show signs of life. Don't ask me how at my age one still can grow. If you met my wife, you'd know.
Dear Frederick, I'm just longing to meet her sometime.
She sparkles.
How pleasant.
She twinkles.
How nice.
Her youth is a sort of present.
Whatever the price.
The incandescent water.
Light?
Of my life. You must be mine.
Yes, I must. I really must.
Now. She flutters.
How charming.
She twitters.
My bird.
She floats.
Isn't that a marvel? What is she? A bird.
She makes me feel I'm what?
A very old man.
Yeah, no. But
I must meet your Gertrude.
My Anne.
Sorry, Anne.
She loves my voice, my walk, my mustache, the cigar, in fact, that I'm smoking. She'll watch me puff until it's just ash. Then she'll save the cigar, but
it's all but you're joking.
She dotes on
your dimples.
My snoring.
Oh, dear.
The point is she's really simple.
Yes, that much seems clear.
She gives me funny names,
like
all dry as dust.
Just
you must meet my wife.
If I must. Yes, I must.
A sea of winds that I submerge in, yet so lovable. Fortunately still a virgin, but you can't force a flower.
Don't finish that sentence. She's monstrous.
She's frightened.
Unfeeling.
Unversed. She'd strike you as unenlightened.
No, I'd strike her first.
Her reticence, her apprehension.
Her